Today, I am going to explain chapter 10 and that name is Coastal Plain and Islands. Now, let's see the chapter. India has a long coastline. Coastline means the edge or shape of coast. You can see in the map, there is a green area. So, that is called the coastline. Coast means sides. It begins from the Gulf of Kutch and ends at West Bengal. The Gulf of Kutch is an inlet of Arabian Sea along the west coast of India in the state of Gujarat, which is renowned for extreme daily tides. Begins means starts. The coastline is divided into eastern coastal plain and western coastal plain. And this green area that is called the coastline is divided into two parts, eastern coastal plains and western coastal plains. Now let's see eastern coastal plain. The eastern coastal plain lies between the Eastern Ghats and the Bay of Bengal. Lies means be in, or you can say remain. So the eastern coastal plain is between you can say in the middle of eastern coastal plains and Bay of Bengal. Means one side of the eastern coastal plain is Eastern Ghats and other side is Bay of Bengal, and in the mid there is the eastern coastal plain. It extends from West Bengal in the north to Tamil Nadu in the south. Extends means to cover the area. So the eastern coastal plain covers the area from the West Bengal in the north direction to Tamil Nadu in the south direction. The average width of eastern coastal plain is 120 kilometers. Average means the normal standard or amount or quality. Normal. So, the normal width. Width means you can say the amount that something measured from one side is called width, or edge to the other. Edge means sides. So the average width of the eastern coastal plain is 120 kilometers. The Mahanadi, Godavari, Kaveri and Krishna rivers flow through this plain. In eastern coastal plain, few rivers flow like Mahanadi, Godavari, Kaveri and Krishna. These rivers form delta in this plain. Form means made. So Mahanadi, Godavari, Kaveri and Krishna rivers made the delta in the plain. In which plain? In eastern coastal plains. Delta means an area of low flat land, sometimes shaped like a triangle, where a river divides into several smaller rivers before flowing into the sea. This makes the region fertile. Because of this delta, eastern coastal plain, that is very fertile land, irrigated and heavily populated. Irrigated means to supply water to land and crops using pipes or small canals, etc. And heavily means very. Populated means to fill a particular area with people. Means a number of people in a particular area is called populated. So because of this delta, that area is very fertile and that is irrigated and heavily populated, means there is lots of people live in that area. Mangrove forest and backwaters or lagoons. Backwaters is called lagoons also, found along this delta. Along means with. With this delta, there are some other things also found there, like mangrove forest and backwaters. So I will tell you what is the meaning of mangrove forest. Mangrove forest means that forests are found on the deltas along the coast. They are also known as tidal forest. Mangrove forest can be survive in fresh water and as well as salty water also. And backwaters means a place that is away from where most things happen, and so it is not affected by new ideas or outside events. The eastern coastal plain is known as the Nadan Sirkars between Mahanadi and Krishna rivers and the Coromandel coast between Krishna and Kaveri rivers. Coromandel coast is the southeastern coast region of Indian subcontinent, bounded by the Utkal Plains to the north, the Bay of Bengal to the east, the Kaveri Delta to the south, and the eastern coastal plain to the west, extending over an area about 22,800 square kilometers. That is about the Coromandel coast. So, eastern coastal plain is known as Northern Sirkars also, and that is between Mahanadi and Krishna rivers and the Coromandel coast between Krishna and Kaveri rivers. Western coastal plain. The western coastal plain lies between the Western Ghats and Arabian Sea. Means western coastal plain is in the middle of Western Ghats and Arabian Sea, and in the middle is western coastal plain. It is narrower than the eastern coastal plains. Narrower means having only a short distance from side to side, means you can say there is a less place. It extends from Gujarat in the north to Kerala in the south. Western coastal plain is cover the area from the Gujarat in the north direction to in the Kerala in south direction. It ranges from 50 to 100 kilometers in width. Ranges means a variety of things that belongs to the same group. So here you can say it ranges near about 50 to 100 kilometers, that is the width of western coastal plain. Many rivers such as Tapi, Narmada, Mandovi and Juari flow in the region. In western coastal area, there are few rivers flows like Tapi, Narmada, Mandovi and Juari. The western coastal plain is divided into three parts. First, the Gujarat coast. Second, the Konkan coast. And third, the Malabar coast. Lagoons or backwaters are found along the Malabar coast. There are three parts of western coastal plain: Gujarat coast, Konkan coast and Malabar coast. So, lagoon waters are found along the Malabar coast. Islands. Now, I will tell you about the islands. a piece of land that is surrounded by water from all the sides is called islands. So let's see, away from the coastal plains are the two big groups of islands. Away means at a particular distance from a place. So from the distance of the coastal plains, there are two big groups of islands. Number one, the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, and the other one is the Lakshadweep Islands. As you know, both names, and these both are a part of Union Territory. The Andaman and Nicobar Islands are located in the Bay of Bengal. Where is located Andaman and Nicobar Islands? In the Bay of Bengal. And they are means Andaman and Nicobar Islands are a group of 572 islands, islets and rocks. Islets means a very small island is called islets, and rocks, you know, a large piece of stone is called rocks. So in Andaman and Nicobar Islands, these all things are included. 572 islands, few small islets and few rocks. They are two islands groups and are separated by 10 degree channel. Andaman and Nicobar Islands are separated. Separated means that is divided into two parts by 10 degree channel. 10 degree channel is a channel that separated the Andaman Islands and Nicobar Islands from each other in the Bay of Bengal. The two sets of islands together form the Union Territory, that you know the name Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Andaman Islands in the south and Nicobar Islands also in the south, but both are separated by the 10 degree channel. The Lakshadweep Islands are located in the Arabian Sea. Where is the Lakshadweep Islands? In the Arabian Sea. It comprises 10 inhabited islands, 17 uninhabited islands and several islets and atolls. In Lakshadweep, comprises means to form or be part of something. So in Lakshadweep Islands, that is included 10 inhabited means to live in that place is called inhabited, and where no one live, that is called uninhabited. So there are 10 inhabited islands, 17 uninhabited islands and several means many small islands and atolls. Atolls means an island shaped like a ring means circle, with a lake of salt water. Lake of salt water is called lagoon also, in the middle. So these all things are included in Lakshadweep Islands. Lakshadweep is the smallest Union Territory of India. You can see in India's map also, there is only point things are there, that is very small. Lakshadweep Island, Kavarati, Kalpeni, Minicoy and Bangaram are the four major islands. Lakshadweep Islands, there are four small islands, or you can say four main islands are there. Kavarati, Kalpeni, Minicoy and Bangaram. Unlike the Andaman Nicobar Islands, most of which are hilly, the islands of Lakshadweep are flat. So, and like the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, most of the areas are hilly, but the islands of Lakshadweep are very flat. means both lands are different. Andaman and Nicobar Islands, that is hilly area, and Lakshadweep and flats.